Now to our series on life beyond COVID. And tonight, what the pandemic could mean for entertainment. When the coronavirus hit, we were already in the middle of a revolution in how we're entertained. And we could be on the verge of even bigger changes. So just what will audiences want? Who will be making it? And how will they do it in a post-COVID world?
The entertainment industry now.
The return of AFL in an empty stadium.
$5 billion lost so far in the film industry.
Organisers pulled the plug on the midwinter arts event.
They'll be keeping customers 2 metres apart.
Welcome to interviews in the aftertimes.
Keith Urban showing that socially distanced concerts are possible.
Well, thank God the drive-ins are still happening.
The most significant challenge for cinemas could actually be just getting us out of our lounge rooms.
This could be the new normal for sports.
So, when can we all go back to the movies?
I don't know if you know, but how long can this go on?
If ever there was a time in history to be confined to our homes, it was 2020, when movies, TV and sport could be streamed in real time to our high-def televisions, tablets and phones. Even the high arts, theatre, opera, ballet, the symphony, have all gone digital during the shutdown.
But no one else is in the room where it happens.
So if every form of entertainment can be delivered to our home, will we ever need to go out again? Technology was on the march well before COVID, but when you add that the pandemic has forced so many art forms to accelerate their use of it, the way technology will shape our entertainment experience in the future is simply mind-boggling.
So the technology will improve radically. Augmented reality and virtual reality will become a mainstay. You might be able to feel the heartbeat of the player at a football match. You might be able to feel the bumps through a haptic suit as if you're on the field. I mean, we're going to go beyond watching to experiencing, you know, with our body physically.
This could expand the very meaning of entertainment as we understand it. And then there's COVID's impact on the content itself. History tells us that seismic global events like pandemics, wars, recessions have profound effects on the kind of entertainment we make, who gets to make it, and what punters like to consume. So, during the Great Depression, for instance, audiences devoured affordable, escapist entertainment, and things like carefree musicals and screwball comedies became hugely popular.
What is the matter with you?
And rock and roll came out of the feel-good moments that followed the end of the Second World War. But this wasn't just a matter of taste. At the time, fuel shortages meant that big ensemble jazz bands could no longer tour, and that led to smaller bands of around 4 members, say, 2 guitars, a bass and a drummer. In cases like these, you can see how entertainment reflects the intersection of the mood of the time, which we might want to reflect or escape, developments in technology and the constraints of economics. So what might we see beyond COVID?
I suspect we will have more shows and content which explore what it means to have human relations in a post-COVID world. We're going to see a lot of horror films that explore the trauma of the COVID experience and the lasting psychological issues that have come out of the social isolation.
But entertainment isn't just about the content or the fancy tech. It's been about the shared experience for as long as humans have existed. Seeing that goal or performance with a crowd of enthusiastic, like-minded fans. It's the stuff of date nights and family outings. It's the catalyst of our social lives. And that craving isn't likely to disappear just because we're watching even more Netflix than usual.
In the short term, we've had to adapt. We've had to be less social and distance from each other. But the human brain hasn't had an upgrade in 200,000 years. It's a really old piece of software. We're going to go back to the ways that we like physical proximity, socialising and getting close together once we get through this.
The most urgent question then becomes whether the places that let us do this will still be there and in what form. Experts warn that we'll be dealing with COVID-19 for years and that another pandemic could be just around the corner. It's likely that cancelled tours, closed theatres and empty stadiums could be a regular feature of life, and the entertainment industry may not be able to cope.
Iconic music venue The Tote has crunched some numbers, and the gigs that they used to charge up to $10 for after COVID might cost up to $60, so I think we can expect to see some ticket price increases.
Increased costs and climbing unemployment may put live entertainment out of reach for many people, and it's unclear what that live entertainment will look like. Ongoing border restrictions mean we might not be seeing international acts for a long time.
If you think of the job of an international tour promoter, at this point there'd be no way to plan to bring an international artist over. We don't know the cost of flights, when flights will be possible, the visa implications, quarantine, who pays for quarantine. I mean, is Beyonce going to fly over, sit in a hotel room for 2 weeks and then play to a half capacity venue? I think it's very unlikely for some time.
This may all seem like uncharted territory, but something like this has happened before. The 1918 Spanish flu wiped out smaller film companies, consolidating power in a handful of big studios and creating the monopolistic movie system we have today. Modern Hollywood is a direct result of a pandemic. So it's possible that we could see entertainment undergo similarly massive structural change again.
What is becoming very clear is that COVID is already changing how filmmakers shoot and how they think about shooting. I think virtual production will start replacing a lot of elements of physical production. Virtual sets, virtual locations will start being used, and lower budget filmmakers may be able to make them more easily.
Imagine that. Imagine if this global pandemic opened the door to all the smaller operators that couldn't survive in the shadow of the massive Hollywood machine created by the last one. And imagine if the future became this meeting point of new technology that might change our whole concept of entertainment and the things we've loved most about the world that we've been forced to leave behind. It's all on the cards with one major rider. We'd need to do everything we can to make sure enough of the old world survives so that the new one can realise its potential.
Yeah, it is a very interesting time. Em and I are both touring comics, and it's just not feasible to be quarantining for 2 weeks in each town before doing the show, potentially to a half-full venue. And the truth is, people say, oh, well, just put your stand-up up online. For me, 10% of my stand-up can be broadcast. The other 90%, you know, it can only be there live.
You've got to say that.
You can't afford the legal fees.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, exactly.